How can I password protect my documents? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Question, I keep a daily journal in Microsoft Word on Windows. Is there a way to put a password on it or lock it up somehow so only I have access to it? There are several approaches to encrypting or locking your documents depending on what tools you happen to be using. Word is a good example of a tool that has this built in. And while it didn't used to be particularly secure, current versions of Word are. Let me show you what that looks like. So I'm going to run Word. I've got it here somewhere, I know that. And create a new document. And just say, you know, new document. And I'm going to save it to disk. Naturally, they suggest I put it in OneDrive. If you don't want to put it in OneDrive, just go ahead and browse to a different location. In my case, I will put it on the folder called T on my C drive. And I'll just say, example. Let's save. So there it is. It's a file on my hard disk that's not protected. So how do we protect it? Well, we'll go over to File, Info. And then here is Protect Document. We'll click on that and you'll see that it says encrypt with a password. We'll click on that and it will ask you to enter a password. As usual, this needs to be the long, strong, secure password, just like any other, but it applies only to this document. So I'm going to use a short password because for these demos, I tend to be lazy, and we'll hit the same password again. So, a password is required to open this document. Fantastic. I'm going to close Word. We're going to save the changes. That's fine. I don't want to move it to the cloud. Now, we're going to open the document again. This time, I'll just navigate over to that folder and double-click on my example.docx. It needs a password. In other words, without this password, this document is inaccessible to anybody other than the people who know the password. And yes, the contents are encrypted, meaning that even if they have the file in their hands and they open it up in some kind of a binary file editor or viewer, it's not going to do them any good. All they will see is digital noise. So I'm going to enter the password. And there's my document. If you want to remove the password protection, we'll click on that, encrypt with a password. We do need to remove the password. Hit OK, and now it's no longer encrypted with a password. I'm going to close Word again. We'll save those changes, and you can see now that if I double click on the document, it'll open right up. What if that's not what we want? Or, even better, what if we have a lot of documents that we want to do this to? So, to encrypt example.docx, what we're going to do is add it to a zip file using 7-zip. Clicking on the file, click on Add. Now you get this fairly confusing dialog, but the first thing at the top here says, what is the archive you are adding this thing to? We don't have an existing archive. We're creating a new one, so it will be called example.zip. The default is often example.7z. That's fine. It's a good algorithm. It's great for sharing with other people who have 7-zip. But the thing about zip format is that it's everywhere. It's supported natively, as we'll see in a moment, in Windows. It's on Mac. It's on Linux. It's everywhere you want to be. So I'm going to suggest you make sure to select the zip format. Then, of course, in order to encrypt it, you need to enter a password. We'll do that twice. And that's really about it. The one thing I'm going to point out here is that the encryption method matters. If you select AES-256, Windows won't understand it. Windows will not be able to decrypt the file. Whereas if you use ZipCrypto, you can. Windows will, as we'll see in a moment. However, if this is important to you, if you want to use AES-256, that's fine. You can still use all of the other zip programs or 7-zip itself to extract the document from the zip file. So with ZipCrypto having been selected, I'm clicking on OK. The zip file gets created, and theoretically, we're done. I'm going to fire up Windows File Explorer, go to that same folder. There's example.docx in its unencrypted form. There's example.zip that has the file in its encrypted form. I'll double click on it, and we can immediately see within inside. That's one drawback to the zip encryption scheme, is that the names of the files in the folder in the zip file are visible. However, attempting to open those files, well, that's a different matter. This file is password locked. This one is password protected. So in order for Windows to be able to open the file, yep, we need to specify our password again. And again, this is the password we encrypted the zip file with. And there it is. We've got the file open. In this case, because I haven't copied it anywhere, it's only letting me look at it. But the bottom line here is that we could, for example, file save as somewhere else or do whatever we wanted to do with the document. So zip files, that is another very simple and cross-platform compatible way to basically make sure that your documents are encrypted fully. Now, there are two other approaches that I want to mention. I'm not going to demonstrate them here because I do have articles and videos on Ask Leo about each of them. One is VeraCrypt. VeraCrypt will allow you to create a container, a fixed size container that you mount. When you mount it, you specify the password for it, and it creates a virtual disk drive. It'll appear as another disk drive. And you could just copy files to and from that vault all you want. Everything stored in the vault is automatically encrypted, and everything you read from the vault is automatically decrypted. When the vault is not mounted, then only the encrypted data is visible, which, as we know, is useless to somebody else. Now, another tool that honestly I'm thinking of using more often myself is Cryptomator. Cryptomator works very similar to what I just described for VeraCrypt, except it works on a file-by-file basis. It's perfect for, as its name kind of implies, uploading to the cloud. In other words, if you've got 1,000 files, if you change any one of them in a VeraCrypt vault, then that entire vault needs to be uploaded. However, if you change only one file in a Cryptomator setup, then only that one file will be uploaded. It'll be encrypted, it'll be uploaded in its encrypted form, but it will only be that one file. And there is nothing that says you have to use Cryptomator on cloud storage. You can have it work on any folder you happen to have anywhere on your machine or an external drive or wherever. So if you're doing this with a lot of different files and you're wanting to protect a fair amount of information, Cryptomator might be the best place to start. Now, I do have to mention what I would consider to be the gold standard for encryption. Not that any of these other encryption schemes aren't great. They are, they're secure, they're wonderful. However, GPG or PGP encryption is public key encryption. It honestly is the basis of the internet. You're probably using it right now as you're watching this video over an HTTPS connection. That is the gold standard for encryption, and you can encrypt individual files. You can do all sorts of interesting things with it, but it is complicated. It's much more than just remembering a password. It requires a bit more of an infrastructure to actually set up and use. So it is something that I mentioned mostly just for completeness. If you're actually wanting to save, I don't know, your nuclear launch codes, it might be the better choice. But for everything else that you and I do in business, in government, and at home, yeah, these other tools, the encryption used in these other tools is going to be just fine. Choose the approach that works the best for you. Chances are, going all the way back to the question that started this, words encryption would be fine. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/2614. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.